Hello, how are you all? So our today's lecture is variables, identifiers and data types in Python programming. This thing we already have done with the C and C++ also, but now we will discuss in Python language. As in our previous lecture, we have a discussion of OOPs concepts in Python programming, and I really get a good comments from all of you, and I want you all to subscribe my channel so that I could get to know that you all are watching my channel. And please comment me whatever is the feedback in my lectures and whatever the discussions you have with me or a queries with you have with me in my lectures. So our today's lecture is variables, identifiers and data types in Python programming. As we all know, variable is a name given to a particular memory location. If we will talk about a variable, if for example, if like we have an example of car, and in car there comes a mileage and name of company. So the mileage of the car is for example 10, and the name of the company is BMW. So these are the variables of the cars. So these variables are used for the particular car, and we can say that any variable, any name given to the memory location is known as a variable. So in memory, in our computer memory, we have large amount of data, and each data have its unique value. So the name given to a particular memory location is known as a variable. And we can update the variable, or we can change the value of the variable, because the variable is not a constant thing. It is a static, and we can change the value. We can change, for example, if this car is have the mileage of 10 and the name of the company is BMW, and if we are using instead of this car, if we are using some other company car which have some other mileage, so we can say that the value varies, or it can be assigned with a new variable, because the values are static, it's not a constant. So each variable have a static value, and we can vary the different values, and we can change the values in the variable. Now it comes the identifiers. Identifiers, as the name suggests, to identify each element in the variable is known as a identifier. So identifier represent each element in a memory location. We can use in identifier for example we are using variables we are using float we are using functions we are using int all these things comes under the identifier. So we can represent a particular name to a element in a identifier as the name suggests of identifier. So before starting with our next, we will have to follow some rules that are being used in variables and identifier. So number one is, in variables and identifier, each keyword has its own unique value. So if we are using the number of keywords in programming, so as we know that each keyword has its own function and their own unique identification. So this is the first rule, that each keyword has its own function. This is the first rule in programming on Python with variable and identifier. So the second point is, it is a case sensitive. Case sensitive means, if we are implementing any value with a variable, so if we are writing here a name and a name also, so in Python programming, both of these variables are different because this the name of this variable starts with a small alphabet and the name of the other variable starts with a capital alphabet. So this is a case sensitive language in Python. So there is a difference between both of these variables in small name and a capital name. So we can say that this is a case sensitive language. So our third point is each identifier start with a character or a underscore, or these characters may be a uppercase or a lowercase. So we can say that each identifier starts with character or semicolon. So we can use a new characters and a semicolons before starting our identifier. So we can use the uppercase or lowercase of the alphabets in this third case of the, or we can say the rules which are being used in a identifiers and a variable. The point is variables can be alphanumeric, that is digits or characters. So whenever we are using our variables, that variables are alphanumeric. That is, we are using our variables or we are using our integers while starting the alphanumeric values in variables or identifier. So these are the various cases which we are using in variables and identifier. As we all know that in programming we are using number of variables, number of identifiers. So identifiers comes under the variables, float, functions, integers. Any of the name representing with variable or identifier comes under this complete description of the programming language, and we are using all these things. The first rule is each keyword has its own unique value and function. Number second is it is a case sensitive language. Number third is each identifier starts with a character or semicolon. Number fourth is variables are alphanumeric. That is, they are using a alphabets or they are using a digits in variables and identifier. Now we will start with the data types in Python. So we have already done that. We come to our next topic of data types in Python. As we all have done this data types in C programming also, but in Python also we are using the data types which are some difference from the other languages. Now, like in data types, we are using the numbers, strings, list, tuple and dictionary. These are the various data types, and in numbers we are using the int, float and complex. And in string, as we know, string is a combination of characters or integers. Strings can be represented as a characters or a string itself. Then it comes a list. If we are creating a data type, we can use the list also. We can use the tuple of rows or columns also. We are using the dictionary also, as we are using the English dictionary or some other thing. So we are using these types of data types in Python also. Now we will start with the C programming. As before starting with Python, I have a value of, before coming to the some value, before representing or declaring some value to int, we have to declare that value. So for example, if we are using int a, then we are using a is equal to 5. So this is a declaration, this is a part of declaration. This is a declaration and this is a initialization. So int a is a declaration and a 5 is equal to initialization. This thing we are using with the semicolon in C programming, and there comes a declaration and initialization, both the things. But in Python there is no need to declare and initialize the value. In Python this is we are using in C, and in Python Python, we can directly write the value a is equal to 5 and there is no need of the semicolon. So in this a is equal to 5, there comes a declaration and initialization both. So we don't no need to represent int a as a declaration and a is equal to 5 as a initialization in Python. We can directly execute the value of a is equal to 5. So this is a difference between a C and a Python. Then it comes a, if we are representing three variables, a is equal to 5, b is equal to 6 and a is equal to b plus c. So in Python, in C programming, we have to use three values, int a is equal to 5, int b is equal to 6 and int a is equal to b plus 3. And we are using the semicolons in C programming. But if we are talking about the Python programming, we can directly write it as a is equal to 5, b is equal to 6 and c is equal to a plus b. So there is no need of the initialization and declaration. We can directly execute the value of a and b and we can write the c is equal to a plus b. So there is one more difference between the C programming and the Python programming, that comes that in C language we are using the semicolon with the end of the each line. We are using the semicolon, but in Python there is no need of the semicolon at the end of the line. So we can write it as directly, there is no need of the semicolon. Then it comes a, if we are writing flag is equal to 0, int is equal to 1 and float is equal to 2. So this can be written in C programming, but if we are using these three things in Python, so we can use it as flag is equal to int is equal to float. So we can use the complete description is equal to 0, 1 and 2. So we can execute the three values in a single line editor. So this is the main difference between C and Python programming. There is no need to write each the things in lines. We can use the values in the, or we can write or execute the value in a single line editor. So this is come in a Python programming and this comes in a difference between a Python and C programming. Then it comes a value of integers. So if we have a number of, if for example, if we have a example of car, so in car we have mileage, company name, color. So mileage is equal to 10, company name is equal to BMW and color is white. So instead of writing all these variables of car, we can write it in a single line also. Mileage is equal to company is equal to color and we can write it as 10 comma so we can write the complete variables, or instead of writing these three things we can write it in Python, we can write it in a single line. So this is the main difference between C programming and Python. So we can say that this programming, Python programming, is very simple as compared to the C language. As for example, we are using name is equal to Python. Name is equal to Python. Version is equal to 3.8. Price is equal to 3000. And C is equal to 4 plus 5 I. So in Python, this comes in between the So this is a spring. This is a spring. This is a float. This version 3.8 is a float value. This is a spring value. And this is a int value. And last is a complex. If we are giving the complete description of this complete data, then it comes, there comes a value of string, float, integer, int value and complex value. So with this example, we can give the complete description of string, float, integer and complex that comes under the data type. So this is the main things which we are using in the data type in Python programming. And if we have to use the, if we have to write the command in C programming, we have to use the sign, and in between we can write the command. But in Python, this comes under the C, but in Python, there is no need to write all these things. We can write the command while using the hash. We can simple use the hashtag for the command. And if we are using the more number of commands, then we can use the more number of hash. Just write the hashtag and then you can write the command in the Python program. So with this, I hope you all will understand this topic of variables, identifiers and data types in Python programming in very easy mode. I hope you all will read it twice at your home also. And I want your subscriptions on my channel so that I came to know that you all are watching my videos and my lectures. So for today, thank you all of you. Be safe and stay home.